ancient Egyptians paid more attention to hygiene and cleanliness than people who lived in later times. During the Renaissance in Europe, it was commonly believed that bathing, especially in hot water, could open the pores to disease, leading to a decline in bathing habits. Instead, people often focused on cleaning the visible parts of the body and changing underclothes to maintain freshness. Furthermore, the infrastructure for cleanliness, such as sewage systems and public baths, which had been widespread during the Roman era, had declined significantly in the Middle Ages and had not fully recovered by the time of the Renaissance. The ancient Egyptians had a high regard for personal hygiene, beauty, and health, which was heavily influenced by their religious beliefs. They believed that cleanliness was necessary for both physical and spiritual purity. Egyptians bathed frequently, often several times a day. They had basins at home for this purpose. The wealthier Egyptians had bathroom facilities in their homes with limestone bathtubs. The Nile River was also a primary place for communal bathing. Natron, a naturally occurring mixture of sodium carbonate decahydrate, sodium bicarbonate, and small quantities of sodium chloride and sodium sulfate, was a key ingredient in many ancient Egyptian hygiene practices. It was used as a kind of soap for cleaning the body and teeth. Natron has antiseptic properties, and it was also used in the mummification process to dry out and preserve bodies. After bathing, the Egyptians often applied various oils to their skin to moisturize and protect it from the harsh, dry climate. Wealthy Egyptians would have had access to a wider variety of oils, as well as imported perfumes and scented oils. The ancient Egyptians used various cosmetics, not only for aesthetic purposes but also for hygiene and health. For example, they used kohl, a mixture of soot and other minerals, around their eyes, which may have helped protect against the glare of the sun and prevent eye infections. Hair care and nail grooming were important aspects of personal hygiene and appearance in ancient Egyptian society. Both men and women paid great attention to their hair and nails, and the practices varied based on age, status, and in some cases, occupation. The ancient Egyptians were known for their elaborate hairstyles. They often used combs, hairpins, and hair rings to style their hair. Wigs were also popular, particularly among the wealthy. They were made from human hair, sheep's wool, or vegetable fibers and were often elaborately styled. Some Egyptians shaved their heads completely, often for cleanliness and to prevent lice, and wore wigs instead. Priests in particular were known to shave their entire bodies for purity. Hair dye and henna were used to color hair and wigs. Children typically had their heads shaved, except for a side lock of hair that was left until they reached puberty. This was likely done to keep them cool and to prevent lice infestations. Manicure and pedicure sets, including tools such as bronze and copper razors, pumice stones, and nail files, have been found in burial sites, indicating the importance of nail care in ancient Egypt. The Egyptians kept their nails short and clean. It's also believed that henna was used to color the nails, as well as the hands and feet. The ancient Egyptians are known to have suffered from dental problems due to the grit and sand left in bread, which wore down their teeth. Evidence of early dentistry has been found in Egypt, including remedies for dental pain and loose teeth. They used chew sticks, and some evidence suggests that they might have used a form of toothpaste. In ancient Egypt, women used a variety of materials during menstruation, including cloth, papyrus, and even materials made from plants. The exact materials used varied depending on the time period and region, as well as the social status of the woman. One common material used was linen cloth, which was readily available and easily washable. Women would fashion the linen into pads or strips that could be held in place by a belt or girdle. Some women may have also used papyrus, which was woven into a type of paper and used as a disposable pad. In addition, women may have used materials made from plants, such as soft leaves or grasses. They also used vaginal duchess made from water mixed with vinegar or honey. The Egyptians wore linen clothes, which were light and breathable in the hot climate. These clothes were regularly washed and kept clean. Many homes had toilets, usually a seat over a pot or a simple hole in the ground. In palaces and large homes, toilets could be more advanced, with a form of running water to wash away waste. In ancient Egypt, waste management was primarily the responsibility of each household, and there were no large-scale organized waste disposal systems like we see in modern cities. Households would often dump their waste, including organic material, pottery shards, and other refuse, in heaps outside the city or village, in designated waste areas, or sometimes in unused corners of their property. Some of this waste was also recycled or reused. Organic waste could be used as compost for agricultural fields. Broken pottery or used building materials could be repurposed in various ways. It's also worth noting that the dry climate of Egypt has helped to preserve some of these ancient waste heaps, providing archaeologists with valuable information about daily life in ancient Egypt. However, due to the lack of organized sanitation systems and by modern standards, waste disposal in ancient Egypt would likely have been seen as unsanitary. Despite this, the ancient Egyptians had a relatively sophisticated understanding of cleanliness and hygiene in other respects, as evidenced by their practices of regular bathing, use of cosmetics, and emphasis on clean clothing.